Hey everyone, today I'll show you how to edit the HorseHead Nebula in the free powerful software called Siril. This is quite capable software really. I think if you master it, you would have less need for Photoshop or any other processing software. As we begin, make sure you have the latest Siril version installed. I'll be using 1.0.0 RC2. I'll put the link below just in case it's helpful. Let me open up the recent image that I took of the HorseHead Nebula. This is a stacked file directly from Deep Sky Stacker. This is how your stacked file should look like. It's pitch black with not much details showing. First, what we want to do is to have a peep at the data to see what we are working with. In Siril, this is easily done by choosing auto stretch from the bottom. What this does is just show you how it would look like if it was auto stretched. This option doesn't perform auto stretch to the picture yet, it just shows how it would look. I've intentionally chosen this horrible photo to show you how it's still possible to make good of this. As you can see, there is horrible vignetting. The stars at the edges are distorted because I didn't use any flattener. There are some marks on the lens that can be seen. I would be tempted to throw this photo in the dustbin, but let's see what we can recover. The first thing I always do to begin with is to make sure the colors are right. Without color correction, I feel I'm blind and can't see what is going on. So let's do color collaboration. To do this, go to image processing, then click color collaboration, and then choose the photometric option. Now write Bernard 33 in the search box and click find. Select HorseHead Nebula and make sure that your focal length and pixel size are correct. My focal length is about 420 and pixel size is about 5.2. Click OK and let it do its thing. Once it's done, it should say photometric color collaboration applied. Next, I want to crop this image. The edges are nearly unusable, so let's go to the red channel and perform a tight crop. Well, that looks better. No doubt there is a lot of gradient in this photo, so we need to fix that. To do this, go to image processing and click background extraction. Now make sure that tolerance is as low as possible and press generate. Green boxes will appear throughout the photo and you want to make sure that the green boxes are not on the nebula bits of the image. So move your cursor to unwanted green boxes and right click. That will remove the boxes. I want to make sure none of the nebula has green boxes on it. Press apply and close. Let's go to the RGB image to see how this photo is looking now. Well, it's not too bad. Now, I want to stretch the image. So firstly, I want to make sure that the image is in linear mode. So go where it says auto stretch and choose linear mode. Once you've chosen this mode, the picture should look unstretched. To stretch the data properly, go to image processing, histogram transformation, and then click auto stretch and click apply. Again, go to histogram transformation and do some fine tuning. Auto stretch can be aggressive sometimes, so you need to turn it down a bit by using sliders. Once you are happy with it, click apply. This image looks fine, but we still need to bring out its colors. To do that, go to image processing again and click color saturation. Here you can select which colors you are interested in dialing up. I'm going to just choose the global settings because I want to improve all colors, not just a particular one. Make sure you are careful with this because you can easily oversaturate your image and that won't help. Well, once you're done, just press apply and OK. Last thing I normally do is to sharpen the image. You can sharpen the image in Siril by going to Image Processing and clicking Deconvolution. Now you have to be careful that you don't overdo this. Just a little bit will do for my picture. Save this in whatever format you want. You can make further edits in GIMP or Photoshop, but I'm happy with this. Let me know what you think of this in the comments below. By the way, if you found this video to be helpful, please subscribe.